Hi there. Today we're going to do an unboxing video of the Delonghi Dinamica with the Latte Crema. We've had the Delonghi Dinamica in for a few months, and they now have it with the Latte Crema system in it, like the Aletta and some of our other models that we sell in the Delonghi lineup. Not tall enough to unbox it right from the counter, so you have to follow me around. So this box has your instructions and a decalcification and a scoop that you can use for your coffee grinds if you want to have a decaf at night. You just put it in your bypass chute. It also comes with a water filter. So this is kind of like your startup kit. All the DeLonghi's come with that. Now, I think they hired me for my muscles. Ooh. So it's very well packaged, secure. So this is the extra special piece that's going to create that lovely cappuccino foam for you. Probably does flatter milk, like a latte as well. There we go. Oh, it's like it's got shrink wrap on it. It's like Christmas around here. So it's great. So if you're not, if you don't want to use it for a milk-based drinks, you're just going to plug in the hot water tap. So you can make true Americanos that way, or you could just use the hot water to add to like tea bags. I'm trying to be gentle and fun. This thing really is wrapped up. So this is the tray. So what I'm putting together, that would be your takeaway pucks, just like the other super automatics. Slides in the front. And the nice thing, again, about the Delonghi Dinamica is the front-loading water. So if you're space conscious about your counter, you don't want to have to lift tanks on and off. Great for that. And there we go. So if you're going to put a filter in this, the filter that comes with it just goes right over top. So go on the front, and they leave you a space so you can just fill right in there with the water if you just pull it out slightly. If you don't want to pull it all the way out. Inside, before I put it back together again, just gonna do a quick shot here of where your brew group would be. So once a week with the DeLonghi's, you wanna open this up and then you want to pull out your brew group. It just gets a little bit of oil residue over time, so you wanna pull that out, give it a rinse with hot water, dry, let it air dry, and then put it back in. And that takes care of your brew group and the coffee oils for you. You'll still have to descale these machines, but it's not the back flushing that's involved in a semi-automatic machine. So you would fill this with water and then slide it in just like that. It's a beautiful brushed stainless look to this machine. So. This machine, the Dinamica we have here, doesn't have the Latte Crema system. We have this machine in white and black. The functionality of both of the machines in terms of the coffee portion will be identical. The main difference is going to be when you want to do a milk-based drink, instead of putting your milk into a cup and holding it here to the desired temperature and texture, it would be programmed into here through the latte system. So this goes in the front. It plugs right in, and the steam will come out of the machine and then give you the desired amount of, I always just say bubbles, but consistency of your milk, starting with the lowest, going all the way to the highest. And the great thing about these Latte Crema systems are that you put it to the clean function after it's made a drink. It'll ask you to clean it. So you put it over to clean, and what it will do is it will take the hot water in from the machine. It'll come down partway down the milk straw that's inside here. Won't interfere with the milk that you have in here, and clean this whole head out. So then you can take this out of your machine and then just pop it in your refrigerator for a few days. And then after that, you'd want to take apart and give it a good clean. So that would just pop right on the front. So as you can see, it will function as you choose your drink, and then everything will go into your cup. So with this one, we have the short coffee right here, the long coffee here, and then you would choose your strength of bean from 1 until 5, and you would just arrow it up and down. If you were going to put coffee with the scoop in the box, it would go right here in the bypass chute, and then the machine would know not to use the coffee grinder. It's going to go right away to the coffee grinds, and then you can make your decaf, or if somebody gives you a bag of lovely dark beans, or they've gone to Jamaica or Hawaii, then you can pop that in a ground coffee in your bypass chute. Since we don't have this machine rinsed out and ready to go, I just wanted to show you, besides this part of the machine, the Dinamica that we do have up and running that you can come in and try and have a coffee with is right here. So the water is already loaded in. The beans are already loaded in here. So it's got a 300 gram bean hopper and a 60 ounce water tank. So I'll get you through quite a few coffees, especially if you're doing espressos. So this is has a nice height clearance for your cups here. So I would hit the bean functionality. So it's got Balzac's in it. It's a great espresso. 100% Arabica bean. So I'm just going to hit the espresso. So it'll grind to the 4 out of 5 beans I just hit. And then it's going to come out here. And then if I wanted to do 2 times, I would hit the 2 times button. And then that same volume of water would come out of both spouts. So I could do 2 espressos at the same time. But at that point, I probably would want to put it really strong and not as long, because it's just double the amount of water that's coming through the coffee that's inside. If I wanted to use the machine for a full cup of coffee, I would definitely hit this button here, which shows a coffee cup, because it's going to grind whatever strength you choose, push through the amount of water that you've saved to come through, say 5 ounces, and then it will grind again without doing anything and push another 5 ounces through. So you get a nice full-bodied 10-ounce cup. It's not just a watered-down 10-ounce cup of coffee. So you can see this lovely crema that came on the espresso here. And it's nice and hot as well. So this machine, if I wanted to now froth some milk for the top of here, I would hold the pitcher and then hit the escape button, but it has a little steam functionality showing on it. And then I would open up the valve and then hold my milk here. So we're going to pause for a second. I'm going to get some milk and then show you that in action. So we're back with some milk. I just had to run to the refrigerator. So you're going to press the steam button here, and then the machine's going to let you know that it's heating up. If you didn't press the steam button and you open up this nozzle, you would get your hot water. It will come out of the same nozzle right here. So I'm going to open up and you'll hear the steam. With these machines, you don't have to do any angles do any work to get your foam for your milk. So I will show you that when I pour it out, what it's doing without me doing any work. And we're going to pour it on top of the now flat shot of espresso that I've done. But you can hear the machine pumping, so you know there's steam. You can hear the steam coming out. So what I do for temperature, you can always get a pitcher with a temperature gauge built in, or one for the side. You'll get used to how long and to froth your milk for how you like to drink it. So right now it's really, really hot for me to touch. Then I just switch to the handle. Then I'm going to turn it off. You're supposed to have a towel right quick to wipe it down, but we don't. So look at that lovely foam without doing any work. So it's going to be delicious, I know it. That's a really good cappuccino. All right. So this machine here would do this for you, but what it does is it takes away the work. So I would set it up over here and choose my cappuccino function or through the drink menu or saved into the My Drink, and the machine would know how strong I like my espresso and my coffee, and then it would put the milk right on top at the same time. Yeah, so I said before, looking at the machines, the coffee part functions identical. It's, both of them are gonna taste fabulous, but it depends on if you are doing a lot of milk-based drinks or don't wanna have to work for your milk. It's great to have this option that you can pop on the front of your machine. So if you wanted to make a cappuccino, then you would dial it up to the maximum foam, and there's a little button on top that will show that to you. And then you would go into your milk drink menu and choose what drink you want the machine to make for you. On the front, there are a lot more buttons, only because you're going to program more things. With this one, you're doing the milk yourself, and then over here, you can program in how much and how frothy you want your milk. On the drink side of things, both of them have the over ice, which you want to make sure you have your functionality set to strong, because the heat from the coffee is going to melt some of the ice. There's a short button, there's a long button, there's a cappuccino, and a latte button, but on this one there's also a milk button. So if you want to just have some frothy milk at night, or if you want to give your children some hot chocolate, you can froth up some milk, add your chocolate sauce, and you'd have a great hot chocolate for the kids. Thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe below and like the video. If you have any more questions, you can contact us at ECS Coffee. We'll be happy to answer any of your questions. Thank you.